I didn't know much about the school. I kind of just went out on a limb and chose the university. I just saw that my coach, Coach Copeland, he was a big man of faith. He wanted good Catholic guys on his team. And I think Ave Maria was just the school I was looking for. I was looking for a school that loved the faith, wanted to live the faith, and taught the faith in the classroom, and just had some guys on the team that really wanted to grow in virtue. So just kind of took a chance on the school, and I just moved across the country and got to Ave Maria. One thing about that I love about Ave is all the guys on the team are there for something bigger than themselves. They're not there just to play basketball. They're there for school, or they're there for because they heard about the school through somebody else. And everyone there is kind of really bought into the team culture. I've played on teams where not everyone is really bought into kind of like the overall team. That's really individualist culture. Everyone there is there for the team. Everybody's happy. Everybody's bought in. Everybody's listening to coach. Everybody's trying to do their role. And everybody there is just, from my past experience, everyone there was a good group of guys to hang around, just not on the basketball court. Off the court, you could always go to them for basically anything. And I could say that about every single one of my teammates at Ave Maria. Off the court, I knew I could trust them. I knew I could go to them. When we beat Kaiser the first time, my first year, that was the first time in school history we ever beat them. And we beat Kaiser, and guys on the team were really, I was new, so I didn't really realize the rivalry with Kaiser. A lot of guys on the team were like, we never beat them. Last year, we always tried to beat them, and we never could. And then we ended up beating them the very first time I ever played them. And also, I got to play with my brother. That also was a really good memory, playing basketball at Ave Maria. But off the court, my second year, we did a retreat. My brother, who's a priest, came down and did the retreat. My favorite memory of that was we all sat in adoration together before the season. We all prayed over our season, and my brother gave a good talk, and we all went back to our rooms and hung out and prayed. It was a good time. I would say the first big lesson I learned is not to put your identity in basketball. And that's a hard thing to do, especially when you love a sport a lot and you put a lot of time and effort into the sport. And, you know, God wants you to use your gifts to perfection. I know, obviously, that doesn't always work out the way you want it to, but not putting your identity in sports, putting your identity in something bigger than something here on earth, putting your identity in God, definitely, especially after a loss, when you lose and, you know, you feel like you're the worst player in the world, or, you know, you're just really upset. To be able to look into the mirror and say, you know, we lost this game. We put a lot of time and effort in, and we didn't get the result that we wanted. But at the end of the day, we still are men of God, and God still expects us to be good men and grow in virtue. And, you know, at the end of the day, God doesn't care if you win or lose. God cares if you go out there and play for your team and play for your school. And at Ave, we get to do it with the Mother of God on our chest. So no better feeling than that. Yeah, what advice would I give them? Ave is bigger than just the sport. Get involved outside of your sport. Meet people who are not maybe on your team. Go to Mass every day if you can. Go to adoration, pray, and that stuff will only strengthen your sports experience, your athletic experience at Ave. Definitely knowing people outside of your sport, doing activities for the school, that only made my athletic career at Ave Maria like better. You know, you build more relationships, you get to know more people, and those people come and support you at the games, and that's all. That the community at the games is an awesome experience. I still talk to all my past teammates at Ave. A lot of them are still actually on the team, so that helps. And even the new guys on the team, the new recruits, they came in for open gym, and I hung out with them last year, and I talk with them, so that's actually a cool experience as well, to see the new people come into Ave and have a relationship with them, and you know, see how they play for God. And that's the best part, I think, about playing at Ave. Some of my past teammates, not that I don't like them or anything, but I don't really talk to them anymore. But at Ave, you know, there's something deeper there that, you know, we still have that bond even after the season's over and, you know, we go on into life. So the title is, I Heard My Mother Speak of You. The title comes from Fulton Sheen. So it goes,
I heard my mother speak of you, all you gallant men dressed in blue. She told me how hard you fought, all the lessons you were taught.
That lovely lady exclaimed your names. She even described your greatest games.
She prayed for you one by one before the game had begun.
Our Lady of Sorrows at defeat, but her prayers aided you to compete.
Mother's name across your chest,
that alone is a success.
Our Lady of Victory at contest true.
how proud you made her.
If only you all knew.
Joyful her voice, most motherly sweet, had all the saints cheering on their feet.
Confident in her holy team, O Virgin most faithful,
defended you in battle like Michael the Archangel.
Made your enemies tremble, her heart and mine resemble.
Thank you for honoring my mother, your talents used for one another.
All you gallant men dressed in blue,
all you gallant men dressed in blue, I heard my mother speak of you.